you, everybody, for coming. Thank you very much for coming. This is a very wonderful event, or for us at least. So I'll let Lisa take over for my introduction.
So this morning was quite the event. A group of people came out to Wes's property and lifted this magnificent piece that we have been working on for a number of months. And he and his crew, against the odds and with the help of several people, including John and Phil and a number of people, got this thing placed. It's a dream come true for us. So we're dedicating this bench personally today to two beautiful human beings. One is my son, Michael Allen Hanks Baxter, and one to his beautiful partner at that time, Samantha Elizabeth.
Yeah. Samantha Elizabeth, yeah. My daughter.
Yes. That's your sister.
Right.
Correct. So Michael was, most of you knew both of them. All of you probably know that Michael was born and raised here in Davis. Sammie was born and raised here in Davis as well. Both of them had colorful lives, very colorful lives. They had their ups and they had their downs. And their ups were high and their downs were low. They had a mutual love of art, and their art it leaves me speechless. Their art was amazing. It was colorful, it was sensitive. Michael would draw things and get just the right look in the eyes of everything. Sammie would paint things while Michael was sitting there doing his spray thing. Sammie would be sitting there painting something, and I'd go, oh yeah, okay. And I know Laura experienced it at her house too. And all of a sudden, out would come this incredible piece of art. So we couldn't think of no better way to honor them and their spirits and all of the things that they loved in this community than to build a bench. The bench was an idea that Laura came up with. Wes, being Michael's best friend for many, many years.
Wes, can you raise your hand, please?
Wes, raise your hand. When John and Laura and Phil and I got together, we decided that we would choose Wes to talk about this project. He happened to have communicated with John Matsulis, raise your hand, John, who, as you know, has spearheaded public art here in Davis, and we're incredibly lucky to have this art in Davis. So with the help of numerous people, Wes, his mom, all of you here, everybody here helped work on this in one way or another. I can name the names, but you know that you helped. We came up, Wes instructed us, piece by piece, how to make this thing. It's amazing. It represents so many different things. All of the different symbols that you'll see on here represent something about Michael, something about Sammie, something about one of us, something about your relationship with one of them. It's a beautiful, beautiful representation.
See the back side. Oh, yeah. It's spectacular.
So I'd like to just go through the different things that are symbolic on here. And if you have a question, question about one thing or another or why it's here, please ask, please say something. So one of the things that was done by a wonderful artist in our town, Alan Jones, would you raise your hand, please? Alan is a ceramic artist. One of Michael's favorite things was the yellow-billed magpie. And we had to have a magpie. Wes, we sat at our kitchen table with Wes, and we said, what would be, both the kids liked skulls. They liked the idea of the Day of the Dead colors, and they just, they loved skulls. Well, that's all it took for Wes to come up with a draft, a drawing of what you see here. It was the most amazing, it was most amazing, Wes, and I can't thank you enough, and I'm blown away by your creative talent. I shouldn't be, but I am blown away by the love and what you put into this for Michael.
Thank you.
Okay, so the skull is pretty obvious as far as the skulls. They both like the skulls. The bird, Michael was deathly afraid of spiders, as some of you may know. So I think it might have been Rachel or Sarah, who, or Toddy, somebody.
Somebody made a spider.
No, somebody decided that the spider should be in there, and Alan made the spider.
Oh.
And it has a little skull in it, keeping in the theme of things here. So then the base, which we wanted people to be able to just sit on and enjoy, is made in the tradition of a serape, or a Mexican seat. Is that what it is? A serape. So we used four feet pieces, and we committed to 4 feet of design, and we all made some of this. Leela made some beautiful things. Laura made this most amazing butterfly. I love this. We made roses, we made dragonflies. I think Toddy decided that there should be a scorpion, if I'm not mistaken, and made the scorpion. Maybe you don't remember, but I think you
did. There's so many things.
Yes, and then there's the snake. And the snake meant a whole lot to Michael. Michael spent a couple of years in a beautiful area in Utah, in the wilderness, where he ate off the land and actually ate rattlesnakes and scorpions as well. I think there's a scorpion. Maybe that's at any rate. So the rattlesnake is a very significant piece. Yes, Delaney. The back of this, as Delaney is showing, is a peacock, and the peacock feathers are. They are just, they speak for themselves. And on the back of where the peacock feathers are, we put the guitar. Both of them like to play guitar. So one of the songs that you're going to hear as we close is a song that Sammie wrote. And both Michael and Sammie love to play guitar. Michael loved to spray paint, so there's a Montana 94 can on here. There's paintbrushes, there's roses. Yes, you'll see a number of skulls. These are playing guitar. These are walking the dog. These are riding bicycles. We had to have that for Davis. And these are having a swig of beer.
Dancing.
And dancing. And all of them were done by John, Michael's dad, my husband. And, I know I've left stuff out.
Okay.
The heart in the middle, I actually did the heart with some help from Wes. Michael used to buy me hearts for every Mother's Day, and everything that he did as far as a present for me was he would get me a heart. So we had to have a heart, and Wes helped me figure that out.
There's a pizza over there.
Oh yeah, there's a pizza. Pizza on this side.
Oh, is there a pizza over there?
Yeah.
Right here. There's a bee for Sammie Bee. And anything else that you see that you would want to know, the cactus, the beauty of the desert, the high desert. This is a dream come true for us. So thank you to everybody who worked on this. You want to get ready to do your song?
Yeah.
And you know who you are. And This will be a place, hopefully, for the community to sit and remember these two beautiful people. The city also will have, the city of Davis is also going to have their own opening. This is a private, this is private tonight, so that we can talk and we'll understand something there. At the time of the Day of the Dead, the Dia de los Muertos, this will be apparently used by the city of Davis for people to gather and remember their loved ones. So it can be used in a number of ways. If you want to feel close to Michael or to Sammie or to yourself or to your relationship with art, music, beauty that is in our community, our family, all standing here and beyond.
Some of you might have seen them play some songs and sing. Those were all written by my daughter Samantha. They're all original songs. They're going to play a song now. Sammie wrote this song about the hopelessness, shame, and misunderstanding of feeling trapped by addiction. The name of the song is Boy Without My Soul.
I'm not afraid to
So, I think there's one more thing we'd like to say. Does anybody have any questions about the bench?
How much does it weigh? I like to know.
How much does it weigh?
More than that. It was close this morning. We had a trailer, and it took a few goes. I think on that last push, Michael and Sammy were there helping. I think John was kind of the sleeper artistic guy, because he came out and every time we met at the studio, he'd make a different skeleton pair along the bottom, and I'd just give him a rough sketch and basically leave him to it, and he took care of the rest. But everyone did really nice work. It was really a pleasure.
I think I mentioned earlier about the HRS. And it stands for Harm Reduction Services, and it's a wonderful organization. I'd like to just take a moment to let everybody here know that there is going to be a benefit. I'm going to let Amy announce that.
So on October 4th, which is a Sunday, there will be a concert that we'll be hosting. That's going to be benefiting Harm Reduction Services at Sacramento. It'd be a good way to come and enjoy it and show support and learn more about HRS if you don't know enough about it. To help reduce the stigma of drug use and heroin overdose incidents. Help keep it from being such a help promote awareness of it and keep it from being such a problem. And it'll be at Mayfield Station October 4th at 2 p.m. There's no charge required, but we do ask for donations to go towards. It's all going to go towards HRS. So it would be a good way to show your support and help promote the whole cause and keep stuff like this from happening in the future if possible. So.
Sharper than this is like.
I'm gonna take off.